the question that we always asked ourselves was, how do we build a PLC that is respectful to the legacy, that meets people where they came from while simultaneously moving them into, I don't want to say the future, I don't want to sound too pretentious about it, but met people where they are and then move them forward, because some aspects of PLC tend to be a little retro. I mean, I think it suits that market. People that do automation tend to be fairly risk averse, and rightfully so. So the question we were constantly asking was, you know, how do we build the PLC that meets them where they are while simultaneously moving them to a little bit better view, or a little bit, sure what the word is, but one that embraces a little more modern view of some things. So that's the question. Respect the legacy, embrace the future. And so when we started developing the Do More engine back many, many years ago, that was the perspective. What would we want it to do if we were the ones out doing this and we had the ability to start from nothing? What would we want it to do? And so that's how we built the engine. Well, then you get to the point to where you're looking at these platforms that have been out for, you know, 20 plus years. What are the limitations in those platforms? If I had that to do over again, if I could redo the hardware and redo it with more modern parts and modern capabilities, what kinds of things would I want it to do? So BRX was the culmination of, you know, taking the Do More engine, taking the things that we learned over many, many, many years in terms of how to build the engine, and then building the hardware that we thought would hit Automation Direct's core customer right smack dab in the middle of where that business is. How do we build a hardware platform that embraces the capabilities of Do More and gives people what they want? And it's, again, it's all about value. How do we cram the coolest, neatest stuff into a package that's going to sit right in the market where it needs to be?